the minister should have used the authority to clarify on the provisions under the law that are not very clear, other than trying to use regulations to determine internal party processes.
The infrastructure for digital campaigns are also inadequate in most of the country. And even where they may be available, they are too costly and inaccessible for various reasons.
This is the stand of opposition party leaders who appeared before the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee of Parliament. The president of the Justice Forum Party, Asumani Basalirwa, was the first.
It is our contention that the roadmap issued by the Electoral Commission will not engender a free, fair, and credible election.
Democratic Party President General Norbert Mao came with the DP delegation. The two party leaders agreed on the declaration of a state of emergency and postponing of the 2021 general elections.
A country can only be stable if it is based on a sense of consensus. Irrespective of whether you are in NRM or in the opposition parties, there must be something that we all want to protect when it is endangered. But when Uganda reaches a position where people just say, let it burn, I think we don't have a spare country as Uganda.
To have their documents verified within the shortest time possible will not have them verified. They will therefore not be nominated in time, and in effect, they will be disenfranchised. If those Ugandans challenge the outcome of the election, what will be the defense of the Electoral Commission?
There were mixed reactions from the committee who sought clarification.
You talked about the national consensus. What is the legal framework in our constitution?
Burundi held elections, yes, but where is His Excellency Nkurunziza? Malawi, since the elections, the rates of infection have been going up and they have lost 16 people. Before the elections, no one had died.
In response, Mao called for more consultations on the elections roadmap to avoid fueling the spread of COVID-19.
In the event that the COVID-19 pandemic continues to make it difficult for physical meetings, the issue should consider engaging all other stakeholders, Uganda Communications Commission, Office of the Attorney General, and relevant organs of state to cause such amendments to the law that will provide equitable access to the state and non-state media.
Postponement of the polls, holding national dialogue, reviewing the constitution, and going for normal elections are the main proposals from DP. The committee meetings continue on Tuesday with the Electoral Commission, Justice Ministry, and National Resistance Movement expected to appear.
Tomorrow we are meeting at 10.
Henry Okurut, UBC.